Hey all, my name is Paul Borosky. I am the owner of Quality Business Plan, and what I'd like to do today is to introduce you all to the financial model that I used when I wrote Starbucks Financial Report for 2020 by Paul Borosky, MBA, which is myself. And in introducing you all to the financial model, hopefully you all be able to see the work and the analysis that went into writing this financial report. So please understand, the financial report does not include my Excel file, and that is separate, it's proprietary, but I do want you all to be able to see that, yes, this information was analyzed and it was put together in a professional format, and there was a process used in order to thoroughly examine a Starbucks from various perspectives. All right, so without further ado, let me go ahead and introduce y'all to my financial report, financial model. So here is the financial model. And the financial model, what I did was I went out and I got information for Starbucks from their 10-Ks and their annual statements. And I pulled out their income statement information. I pulled out their balance sheet information. And then I summarized it and I put it into my financial model that I created. And so the financial model ranges from 2016 to 2020. Once I put this information in, the financial model then breaks out each line item and then compares it to different aspects of the organization. So for example, once I finished inputting all the information for the finance, for the income statement, it then populated the revenue section. And then the revenue section, it shows that Starbucks generated approximately $21.3 billion in revenues in 2016. Over the next 3 years, the organization was able to continually grow their revenues to 2019, which ended the year at $26.5 billion. However, in 2020, the organization's revenues declined sharply to $23.5 billion, which is a growth rate of a negative 11%. Fortunately, though, over the last 5 years, in average, the organization was able to generate a 2.8% revenue growth. So from that information, then what I would do in the financial report is just explain, you know, what may have impacted the organization's revenue in 2020, which may have been the pandemic. However, the organization over the last 5 years, they had moderate growth. They are a mature company and it reflects in their consistent, steady growth. The next thing that I did was I analyzed the information for the balance sheet. So for the balance sheet for Starbucks, I again gathered the information from 2016 to 2020, summarized and populated this information, and then I broke out each line item into so I can analyze each one of them individually. And for this example right here, we've got cash. So cash for 2016 for Starbucks ended the year at $2.1 billion. However, over the next 4 years, the organization would be as high as $8 billion and then as low as the $2.1 billion, which was 2016. However, they're all over the board. There's no consistency in the cash. The organization had consistent revenue growth for the last 5 years, except for the actual last year. However, their cash management is all over the board. So this tells me that the organization's management team is not doing such a great job with managing their cash. You know, they should probably be closer to 14% of total assets as compared to cash. But in 2017, 2018, the cash balance went up too high. And that shows that they probably mismanaged that asset. They could have used the cash, whether it be for future investments. They could have paid out higher dividends. There's a lot of things they could have done with that cash instead of having it sit idle in their checking account. In my opinion, mismanagement of current assets, mismanagement of cash, they need to do a better, more consistent job. So that's the kind of a foundation that I use in which to make my financial analysis. The next section was my financial ratios. So again, once I was done with the income statement and once I was done with the balance sheet, putting all that information into my financial model, I then calculated 15 or 20 different financial ratios, from the liquidity ratios, asset utilization, profitability ratios, long-term debt. And then once I was done calculating these ratios, I then broke out each one of the ratios and I show y'all in the financial report how I calculated it. Current assets divided by current liabilities equals our current ratio. And then what I did is for the popular ratios, not for all ratios, but for the popular ratios, I'll then give you some analysis, a brief analysis, telling you my thoughts and ideas. You know, for example, 2016, the organization did a great job, 1.05 with their current ratio. 2017, 2018, they didn't do a very good job managing their assets. And we kind of talked about that with the cash position. In the same years where, you know, they're growing, their cash position, and it's impacting their current ratio. They did a better job in 2019 and 2020, though, for getting that back in line. So that's right there. The company overall, they do a pretty good job with the current ratios, except for 2017, 2018. That shows inconsistency. If there's inconsistency in managing the current assets and current liabilities, then it's going to make some investors wonder, is the organization really optimally, or have they really optimized operations because they're not managing the cash and other assets properly? And it's a foundation to do a more in-depth analysis, just focus on their current assets. All right, so hopefully this information is helpful and y'all have a better insight as to what I use as a foundation for my financial analysis of Starbucks for 2020. If y'all are interested in picking up my financial report, please do so. All you have to do is go to qualitybusinessplan.com/Starbucks financial statement and financial ratios analysis. Scroll down a little bit and just click the buy now button. And you are off to the races. You'll be able to download a PDF file showing the information of the report, the analysis, and all the other good stuff that's included in it. But again, please keep in mind, the Excel file is not included in the financial report. I do take out information and copy and paste and put it in there and discuss it, but the actual file is not in there. All right, so hopefully the video was helpful. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up on YouTube. And if you like the report, please go ahead and purchase it on my website. As always, have a fantastic day. Thank you.